If you can feel the buzz behind me at Jenny Craig Pavilion, you know that it's almost time. The CIF Open Division Championship just about to tip off between the top-seeded St. Augustine Saints and the second-seeded Torrey Pines Falcons. This is going to be a very interesting game. A lot of interesting cross matchups here. You know, the question for Saints, how do they guard the interior sides of Jake Gilliam and, of course, Ethan Esposito? For the Saint, for Torrey Pines, how do you keep up with the pace of the Saints? We're going to try to run the floor. They're going to try to get easy buckets in transition and tire Jake Gilliam out. So it'll be interesting to see. And, of course, you've got the ultimate of all cross matchups, the coaches. John Olive, Mike Hawt, two of the best coaching minds, not only in San Diego, but in all of Southern California. It will be a chess match. It'll be an exciting chess match. And we're looking forward to an excellent game between the two top teams in San Diego County. Now let's see who goes gets the ship. It's a nice drive by Kimo Ferrari. Look for the finish later on in the game. Good drive by Helford. What a drive by Hayden Helford.
You just want it. You just want it.
It's a big shot. Cade hasn't had a, you know, offensively gifted. Oh, good finish. Great finish by Jose Lara. That's what they got to do. They got to push the pace. Nice hustle by Ferrari, the freshman. Good pass. Oh. Gives it to Helford. Let's see. Nice move. Good block. Oh. Taeshon giving the Dikembe. No finger wag, but definitely the head shake right there. And Jack Peterson. He's had to declare Mount McKenna, a D3 school in Pomona. Had an excellent career for the Saints. Torrey's looked discombobulated on the offensive end. That doesn't happen too often. Oh. Big time block there. Taeshon for three. Wow.
3 point bomb.
That's been the big improvement in Taeshon's game.
The CIF supports the highest.
That accurate three-point shot. You can't leave him that open, give him that much time. Oh, Lord. Wop. Yep.
3 point bomb, Taeshon Cherry.
1 point, 15 and under team. When Taeshon was an eighth grader and Jake was a, oh, good move. And one. Nice play by Finn Sullivan there.
You gotta execute better. You gotta catch the ball in better areas. Their physicalness is making us catch the ball all over the place. Catch the ball in good areas. Be tough.
You can't leave him open for that. Oh, good move. Good block. Sabuzo, the freshman. Jake's got to get down court. This is what happens.
Basket by Otto Taylor.
Right. Come on. That might be Jake's first rebound in the game. And the guards leave him, quite naturally. Come on, Ethan. Oh! Don't, are you serious? Are you serious? That's terrible. It's gonna be a tough climb back for Torrey Pines. They gotta cut it to at least within 10 for the end of this quarter. Oh, Seal. Good pass. Big shot.
Three.
Good Jack Peterson layup. Nice. Oh, almost. Oh. Jake blocking his one teammate. Ooh, Cade. Block. That would be a blocking foul. Yep. Finn for three. Big time shot by Finn Sullivan. Oh, nice move by Gilliam. Up six, minute and a half left. Great pass. Oh, good finish by the freshman. Hayden for three. Oh, good board. Jake starting to pay dividends. The big difference in the game has just been a few more free throws by Saints, who've been able to attack the rim and really, you know, get some pressure on Jake Gilliam, you know, getting it up the court at a faster pace so they can attack before he gets settled into a defensive position. And it's paid dividends marginally, but right now, those five free throws and one more three-pointer made is the margin, 25-17. For Torrey Pines, they just need to settle down on offense. A lot of hurried possessions, a lot of, you know, empty possessions where they're not getting any rhythm or ball movement on the offense. If they can right the ship, this should be a more competitive second half. Ball in to Gilliam. Out to Helfrich. Big three. Big shot. There you go. 5-point game. Running right up the middle. Good pass. Oh, good. Wow. 25-20. Saints leading. Smart. Oh, Helfrich again. 2-point game. Hayden Helfrich, two big threes. Coach's son. Let's go. Turn around. Let's go, Kimo. Uh-oh. Jets. Four. This is a 12-0 run to start the second half. Nice little cross matchup right there. Espo. Couple more buckets. Helfrich for three. Oh, man. Oh, man. You don't want to touch him right now because that boy is on fire. That's beautiful. Good curl. He's playing a hell of a game.
Play in the third period.
Got it. Look at that defense. Oh! Oh, wow. Oh, wow. That's bad. Wow, he could get ejected for that.
Hey, let's crank it up defensively and then stick it down their throat offensively. We're avoiding too much contact. I'll stick it down their throat and give them one shot only. If we don't have transition, let's get it in the box, okay? All right. Nothing floating out. Everything at the rim. And what you did is you took one more dribble at Jake and then you ran him over. Instead of the floater where he hits you and we don't get anything.
Oh, good move. Merciless. Oh, wow. Woo! Bottoms. Oh, wow. That is what you call team rebounding. It's 36-40, Torrey Pines leads. Here you go, guys. See it? Taylor, again, playing some of the best basketball of his career in this postseason. Great pass. Wow. That's a hell of a pass. Don't foul. Nice, Taeshon.
Taeshon Cherry.
Oh, what a move. What a finish. Jake Gator Gilliam. That is impressive. Taeshon. Ooh, good block. He's open. Taylor for three. Bang! Saints have the lead, 45-44. The go-ahead three. Oh, spoke too soon. I can barely hear myself think. That's it for Jake. Jake has just fouled out of his. Wow. Foul Ferrari. Hey! Offensive foul, wow! Oh man! What a play by Finn Sullivan! Here we go. We got a gut cutter here, guys. Oh, good motion! Gonna make the first, miss the second, let's see. Oh my goodness! We've got a lane violation by Taeshon Cherry! No, there's 0.5 left on the clock! Torrey Pines needs a miracle, but they do have the ball. And that's it. Saint Augustine is your CIF Open Division champion. 47-44, Saint Augustine with the win. We've had some really spectacular finishes here today. And of course,
make sure you admit you didn't pick us.
Come on, come on. I didn't pick you. Come on, Mike. That's right. I didn't pick the winner in this game. I picked Torrey Pines. But as you look and see behind you, St. Augustine victorious, 47-44, your final score. We, like I was saying before I was interrupted by the victorious coach, Mike Hutt, there have been some really amazing finishes, and this one was probably the best one of them all. Both teams trading blows in the final minutes when Otto Taylor hit that dagger three-pointer to give Saints a lead after trailing for most of the second half. Credit to Torrey Pines. They were down big in this game, 25-17 at halftime. Next thing you know, you're looking up. Torrey Pines is up 40-32 in the fourth quarter. Absolute, excellent execution by Torrey Pines. But down the stretch, Saints made play after play, and it wasn't just a big wave, just a free throw here, a layup here, spread out over the course of 5 minutes, and then capped off by that big shot by Otto Taylor. Big time shot. He was your player of the game. Really picked up the slack for some of other Saints' other scores. Torrey Pines, of course, they continue to battle. Had some opportunities to tie and win the game down the stretch, but they were unsuccessful. Now, for both of these teams, they're both going to be headed to the state playoffs. Where they're going to be will be determined tomorrow. There's a chance that both these teams could represent Southern California in the state regional in the open division bracket. We'll have to wait and see tomorrow to see what CIF CIF says. Until then, both teams are going to have to just, you know, really quickly get over this. Saints, the celebration is short. They'll be back in the gym. Torrey Pines, that down feeling that you have from losing, it's got to go away really fast, because you've got to get right back into the swing of things and prepare for state. This is Full-Time Hoos with your post-game report.
Yes. You vote us number one all year. Uh-huh. I appreciate that.
I have.
Why the switch? Why the switch?
The reason why, and it was playing itself out for most of the game. That mismatch in the middle with
it doesn't matter what happened in most of the game.
I know.
We won the game.
No, I know. It's
nobody gave us credit for what we were about.
I gave you credit.
No, you did not. You Victory Pines.
But what did I say?
Say you're sorry. Say you're sorry.
There will be no such a. I will say good job. Congratulations.
That's a shame. That's a shame.
I'm sorry, man.
Thank you.
But listen. Come on back. Come on. Now, I did say in the game, during our podcast, that a lot of it would be dictated by the pace and the tempo. And you guys did a really good job in the beginning of getting up and down, getting.
Trying to justify his pick. It doesn't matter. We won the game.
I know. Close only matters in horseshoes and hand grenades.
Yeah.
And he's going to gloat until they lose in the first round of the Open Division playoffs.
Oh, wow. That is messed up.
I'm playing. No, I'm kidding.